Hello everyone, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. On today's feature, we're doing a little bit of an impromptu video. I actually discovered that this application called Walling, and it was posted a couple of times on my Twitter page. Ryan Hoover shared a little bit of a sort of like a video of it on his page. He's the founder of Product Hunt, and I'm a big fan of Product Hunt. And naturally, I thought I'd do a little bit of a first impressions on this application. It sort of markets itself as a better way to organize and refine ideas. It looks a little bit like if Trello, Taskade, and Notion had a baby. It's got the sort of classic sort of white and black design that Notion has, whilst retaining the sort of roundness abilities of Taskade, but has a very similar column ability like Trello. So what we're gonna do in this video is I'm actually just fresh off. I'm literally gonna open this application, not installed it before, and I thought I'd give you my first opinion. So let's dive into Walling. Okie dokie, so we're on the homepage here. It does have a few bits of information about the quick tour. Let's look at the pricing because, you know, it's important to know that when we start. So it looks like it says that Walling is currently available on web and macOS, but they don't have an iOS and Android version. They have a 7-day free trial. Zoom in here. And then it's $4 per month for unlimited bricks and walls. I quite like the concept of it, but I guess it's stealing sort of the concept that many companies have had, like Notion, like Blocks, that sort of... Blimey, it's just started raining awfully. So they also offer workspaces for teams with centralized billing for $6 per month per team member, which isn't bad, but let's take a look and sign up for this application. Okay, so apparently it's loading my walls, so this should be quite cool. I'm not sure what to expect with this application, if I'm honest. I feel like a lot of things are going to be sort of pinched from Notion and Taskade, but let's see. Okay, so here we go. First out, it definitely looks like Notion because you've got this sort of sidebar that looks almost identical to it. And you get sort of met with no onboarding, but you have the ability to create a wall. So I'm going to go ahead and press Command J, probably different on your computers. But let's start a new wall and let's maybe put like Christmas ideas or Christmas present ideas. Just start of sort of collecting them. And you can, once you create a wall, you can actually put it into a collection. So this is sort of similar to like an app like Milanote, but let's say it's just a personal item, seeing as work isn't there. It's just come up in the corner, they got a 50% off, which I would just dismiss because I haven't even started using it yet. So it's probably something the team should note. So here we go. I can see straight away that you can create a section title. So maybe these are the column concepts. So I could put family and create a new brick. So the brick is created within this section, but you can create different sections. So if I went and made one for friends. And what I quite like, I guess, is the new section thing, because obviously you've got sort of like Todoist in terms of like creating a new section. But you can see it appears in this sort of like collection up here. They've got an example one here for organizing your life. Their example one includes like shopping lists, living. This could be organizing your home, I guess. Some to-do lists for the car and changing the air filter. A little bit of a guide. I like how the images come in. Let's try and go and create something relatively similar to this. So in this case, I'll like start dumping ideas for Christmas presents in here. You know, and these are fake ones. So if my family's watching, this isn't what you're going to be getting. So I'm going to paste the embed there, and every time I'm doing this, it seems to be freezing. And I don't know whether it's me or whether it's the rain outside. Okay, for some reason, doesn't seem to be working with the links. So if I go and paste the URL and try and enter it, freezes up on me. Okay, so you can already tell this application's pretty early days. So let's instead go and sneak this image instead and paste it into here. So I do have a visual sort of idea. And obviously, if I was able to add a link, I could. I think that's probably just a bug. Let's open this up in full. Now I've got the image. So images sort of spray in line, which is quite nice. And let's say I could just put a little bit of a header here, just below it, and I could say the tea set, seat set from John Lewis, maybe. And you can add more details as well if you had any ideas, for example, a checklist and some text as well. So that could be a good way to add images. The images were fairly easy to add as well. That's something I noticed. So what you can also do is you can what's called resolve your brick. So this is actually a way to complete the task. I can get it back if I press show and I can see the resolved bricks, which is quite cool. You can see that the actual URL posted in here, which I did before. So it seems to have like a slight delay, which is strange. And if I wanted to unresolve the brick, I could bring it back in the options. Now, if I wanted to as well, I could move the brick to another section. I could, for example, move it to friends, and I could move it back by dragging it as well. So you do have the functionality of both doing it through options and there. And you can also move it to another wall, which is a cool idea too. And also you can change the background color of it as well. And it sort of reminds me of like Google Keeps in allowing you to do that. You can also remove the brick too, and also add it to my desk. We're going to add it to my desk, but we'll come back to that in a moment because I quite like this concept of my desk. But let's see how it works out in practicality. So I'm going to go ahead and create a new wall for the course that we're doing, the to-do course coming and work. So I'm going to go ahead and create this wall. And obviously I get a blank canvas, but I could be like things to do. And I'm going to go ahead and create a brick by pressing Control B. And we're going to say launch checklist on where to post this out on. And we're going to start with a little bit of a checklist. Let's add a few items. Okay, so I've added a few items there, and the great thing is you can move this about. So if I wanted to create the launch banner to start, I can do that. You can actually move this section about, whether it's inside of here, if you had multiple checklists, or you can move it to another area, which I think is pretty cool. So that's just by doing the add checklist ability, and you can also add files as well. So for example, if I wanted to add the course picture, I could do as well, and you can see it embedded below there. Now, if I wanted to as well add this brick to my desk area, I can do that too. And if I wanted to as well, I could create different sections for the different activities I've got. Just going on to this area, this is quite a nice view. I quite like the fact that you've got these sort of like, you know, created by, and you sort of got your profile photo there. If I had my own personal account, I'd have the one different from there. I noticed as well that you can resolve sections. So for example, if this project was completed, you'd be like, resolve it, and it remains in the archive section. And also here, you can add numbered areas as well as interact inside of comments. So for example, you can add a comment, you can hide the item, remove item. But what's quite nice is it sort of allows you to do numbered lists, which I think is a pretty decent feature. Now, if you want to add a new brick to any of the sections, you can either tap it up here, or you can use this feature up here, adding a new image or a new bookmark. So for example, if I wanted to go ahead and add that John Lewis thing, it looks like their links don't currently work, which is a bit of a pain. But there's also quick search, which might come in handy. So for example, if I wanted to find the launch banner that we mentioned at the start, let's see if it can go and find that one. Okay, so it searches within the walls that you've already got. So that's something just to note. Now up here, you've also got clouds, savings, notifications if you had a workspace running. I'm on what's called walling premium, which gives me unlimited bricks for 7 days. And also a dark mode is embedded too. There's also settings as well. The settings is very basic at the moment. You can only change your name and the profile image, which I guess is handy. And up here, you can add a collection if you wanted to. So let's say you had a social one or a professional development, whatever it could be, but it might be a nice way of sort of separating things out. Now, also, you've got the ability to invite and create a shareable link to each area, which I guess is fairly handy. It sort of reminds me of the way that you can do it with Trello boards. But as you can imagine, each user will be charged for the premium. So naturally, you're going to be adding up $6 per month per user per workspace. And up here, you've got what's called My Desk. Now, My Desk isn't broken into sections, although you can actually have that there. It actually breaks it down based on sort of what's key to focus on. So the one thing I'll note as well is, remember when we added the image here? You can actually add an image that is sort of outright. So let's just add this thumbnail that I created yesterday. That's actually its own block or brick, sorry, from the outset, which is good. So you can actually add a comment or caption as well as remove it from the desk. And in this case, if you wanted to add a new item, so for example, if you wanted to add some text below to it, it will just turn it into that sort of like different view. But the annoying thing is, I don't think you can actually get out of it, which is a bit of a pain. There we go. So if you go backwards on the text, it actually great comes out of it. So this could be a handy sort of good starting point, I guess. So that could be handy for like being able to share stuff. So here they have sort of a basic outline of the popular shortcuts, what is my desk theory, and the flexibility of the platform. But you're probably wondering, is this suitable for you? And if you're already using an application like this, like Taskade, Trello, maybe Notion, don't necessarily go for this because I noticed it was very buggy at the start and it's very early days. So you want to see how this application evolves before necessarily jumping on board with it. However, if you're looking for something that could be a little bit further than, say, Google Keep, then this could be a good alternative to you. It does remind me of Zoho Notebook mixed with Google Keep, and it has this really aesthetically pleasing experience. I think the USP above, say, other applications is the ability to create collections, and that's against, say, applications like Google Keep and Zoho Notebook, and also the ability to the My Desk area. I think the My Desk area is a pretty cool feature in terms of having like a focus point to then go in and actually start with this bit of work and sort of jump in. Now, you can create different workspaces down here, something I didn't mention, and I'll include all the details below, including the product hunt link. But as I said, it's just introducing you to an application. It's just making sure that you're comfortable with it. So if you're watching this review as they're sort of growing, let's keep an eye on them. Let's see what they do. But as you can imagine, a good aesthetically pleasing start with a few bugs involved and an application that might replicate an existing experience you already have. So be careful. I'm impressed slightly, but I will keep an eye on this application and see how it grows. Anyway, guys, if you're new here, please do subscribe to this YouTube channel and feel free to keep an eye on videos we post. We post on a range of videos. If you want to check out Notion, you can do. Obviously, that's a big feature here on the channel, so do check it out. And I look forward to seeing some of your comments on walling. Anyway, guys, I'll see you very, very soon. Cheers, everyone. Bye.